This is part 5 of solving absolute value equations. We'll be solving equations where there's an absolute value expression on each side of the equation. Something that looks like this example: the absolute value of 9 minus 4x equals the absolute value of 2x minus 3. Before doing that, consider the absolute value of negative 5 is really the same thing as the absolute value of 5. So what you notice is when you take the absolute value of negative 5 and you take the absolute value of 5, both of them equal 5, right? So either you could have something like just the absolute value of 5 equals the absolute value of 5, that's a true statement, or the absolute value of negative 5 equals the absolute value of negative 5, and I can't think of anything else where if you have a 5 or a negative 5 in the absolute value, it can equal some other number, other than these three examples I've shown you. So basically what you notice is either the two things in the absolute value are opposites of each other, as in the absolute value of negative 5 equals the absolute value of 5, or they're exactly the same. In other words, certainly this is true, absolute value of 5 is absolute value of 5, and this is true, absolute value of negative 5 equals absolute value of negative 5. So here's the key. If you have the absolute value of some stuff equal the absolute value of some junk, all right, you can call it anything you want, then these two things are either exactly the same thing, so you could write that the stuff equals the junk, or they could be opposites. So you could write that the stuff is the opposite of the junk. Now, don't put a minus sign in front of both of them, because if you did that, you'd be back to the original one we wrote, stuff equals junk. All right, now, I'm just using the word stuff and junk to show you it doesn't matter what's in there. It might be an x, might be a 2x minus 5, etc. So here we go back to this example, and let's do it for this problem. So what I have is inside this absolute value, 9 minus 4x, and inside this absolute value, 2x minus 3. So either those expressions are equal to each other. 9 minus 4x must equal the 2x minus 3, or I put a minus sign in front of one of them. It really doesn't matter, but remember to use your distributive property. Think of what's inside of there as in parentheses. So I'm going to go ahead and just write 9 minus 4x is the opposite of 2x minus 3. I could have written the opposite of 9 minus 4x equals 2x minus 3. Put the minus sign in front of one of the expressions. Okay, again, I'm only using this when there's just an absolute value on both sides. I don't have like an absolute value of something plus some other number. All right, so now we have to solve these two equations, right, separately. So for the first one, I'm going to put the variables on the right-hand side of the equation, so that I have a positive number in front of x. So I'm going to add 4x to both sides. So I'll have a 6x on the right-hand side, and I'm going to go ahead and add 3 to both sides to get rid of the constant on the right side. So I'm also going to add 3 to both sides. So I'm adding 4x plus 3 to both sides of the equation. And on the left side, 9 plus 3 is 12, so I have 12 equals 6x. Divide both sides by 6, gives me x equals 2, or actually I wrote 2 equals x, but that's the same thing as x equals 2. So we'll check that in a minute. So that's what we got. If they were, the two expressions inside the absolute value were equal to each other. Now we need to solve this other equation, where one might be the opposite of the other. So I have 9 minus 4x equals negative 2x plus 3. Remember to distribute your minus sign to both terms inside the parentheses. Okay, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to put my variables on the right. So I'm going to add 4x to both sides. Remember, there's a lot of ways to solve a particular equation, so you might not put the variables on the right side. That's just how I'm showing it. And let's see, if the variables are on the right, I'm going to subtract 3 from both sides. So what does that give me on the left side? That gives me 6 equals 2x. And we'll just divide both sides by 2 so that I get x equals 3. Actually, I'm reading it 3 equals x and then writing it as x equals 3. But we definitely want to check each of these solutions in the original equations. All right, so to check, we write the original problem down again. So here we have some space. We write the original equation down again, and we're going to plug in 2 into for x. So we have on the left side here, we simplify inside the absolute value using the order of operations. So 9 minus 8 is in the order of in the absolute value. 9 minus 8 is 1, and then the absolute value of 1 is 1. Now we're going to plug in 2 on the right-hand side. And I wrote that as a parentheses, but this is really an absolute value sign. There we go. And so I've got 4 minus 3 in the absolute value, which is absolute value of 1, or 1. So 2 is definitely a correct answer, because I checked it. And now we're going to plug in 3 into the original equation as well, and make sure it checks. So I have 9 minus 12 in the absolute value, that's the absolute value of negative 3, and the absolute value of negative 3 is 3. And on the right side, we're going to plug in 3 as well for x, and use your order of operations. So we've got absolute value of 6 minus 3, which is the absolute value of 3, and the absolute value of 3 is 3, so it checks. So 3 is also a solution. So this particular problem has two solutions. So the answer is both 2 and 3. These can get a lot more complicated, but in this video I'm just going to go over ones where we have an absolute value equaling an absolute value. All right, here's another example. We're going to solve for n. Absolute value of 2n plus 5 equals 2n minus 1. So either these expressions inside the absolute value must be the same. In other words, 2n plus 5 equals 2n minus 1, or they're opposites. 2n plus 5 equals the opposite of 2n minus 1. So we have two equations to solve. And boy, look at this one on the left. If we try to solve for n, you subtract 2n from both sides, and let's say we wanted to subtract 5 from both sides, I get that 0 equals negative 6, which is a false statement. So there's no solution here. So we don't get any number that works when the two are equal to each other. All right, let's look over at the other equation we wrote where they're opposites. We have 2m plus 5 equals negative 2m plus 1. And now we're going to add 2n to both sides. And notice this time we're not going to have that problem where the variables cancel out. We have 2n plus 2n, so we have 4n equals negative 4, divide by 4, so that n equals negative 1. Now each of those should be checked in the original. Let's see if we could do that kind of quickly, the check, without showing every single step. If you put in negative 1 right here and right here, is that going to check? So inside the absolute value, I'm going to have negative 2 plus 5. Can you see that? 2 times negative 1 is negative 2 plus 5, which is 3. Okay? And on the right-hand side, I'm going to have 2 times negative 1, which is negative 2 minus 1, that's going to be absolute value of negative 3. And hopefully you're convinced that the absolute value of 3 is equal to the absolute value of negative 3, because both are 3. So that would be sort of a quick check. So here's a summary of all the problems I've solved in parts 1 through 5. First, we had how to solve equations of the form the absolute value of some stuff equals k. So if you isolate the absolute value, you'll have one of these three cases. And now we've gone over how to solve equations of the form where one absolute value is equal to the absolute value of one thing is equal to the absolute value of something else. Either the two things in the absolute value are equal, or they're opposite to each other. And the main thing on all of these is to always check your answers in original. In the original problem. Okay, have fun.